Hey Bart, how much would you sell that for?
That
painting that Bart created.
The unfinished painting.
Maybe like 100 grand.
Wow. What the fuck?
Who do you think you are?
You know what, Bart?
It's unfinished too.
You don't value your work enough.
Really?
You really don't.
I thought I valued it enough.
No, you don't. That's super cheap.
Really? 100 grand?
There's a guy who tried to sell his childhood painting for $2.3 million and it looks like this.
That's incredible.
I want it.
That's a good troll.
That's pretty tight, actually.
$2.3 million.
Ant horse.
So, wait, how old was he? This is really good.
That one got a plant growing out of a horse's back.
That's good.
It's mantis.
Now I know how much scribble Taika's doing all over the fucking place if you think that's good.
You should. Can you show them your laptop?
I've seen
this laptop. Sell this laptop.
I left my laptop alone.
Unsupervised.
For like 1 second.
Oh my god.
Flew all over here.
Did you try to take it off with alcohol?
No, I actually liked it. Yeah, I saw it and I'm like, oh, it's Taika. So I kind of want to give him more markers.
So you could fuck up your whole laptop.
But just don't touch the glass.
It's really going to happen.
Take off the glass.
You guys are a good duel for parents, man. I would have
beat the shit out of him.
Mm-hmm. No, but instead, it's good because they're teaching him all great life lessons, which is if he vandalizes property, he gets rewarded for it.
People love him harder.
Yeah, that's amazing.
Well, there's graffiti artists that are millionaires.
Well, they do it the right way, though.
Yeah. Who are the millionaire graffiti artists besides Banksy?
I don't know.
And we don't even know about Banksy, right?
I'm pretty sure Retina's a millionaire.
Oh, yeah? Okay.
His work is.
And the cat who did the Facebook thing.
What Facebook
thing? David Cho.
Yeah.
True. Oh, he actually is.
He's a fucking crushing it.
Yeah, multi-millionaire.
Multi.
But anyway, back to this thing. So, this guy, he's a 41-year-old journalist, and he placed an ad for this drawing here on the Russian classifieds. And so, he was asking for 140 million rubles, which is about 2.3 mil.
Wow.
And so what he's actually saying this is at a discounted price.
It's discounted.
Oh.
When he drew this when he was 6 years old, and he says reason why it's so precious, he said, when I painted this picture, I was small. It was Soviet time. In my works, I reflected the reality that came to us from TV screens, from books. I was interested in the theme of the Civil War in that period. So he's saying this is a little insight into Soviet Russia, like Soviet times, through a six-year-old's eyes.
But it's damaged because there's a crease down the middle, which means he folded it and put it away somewhere.
Yeah.
That is unfolded.
Yeah.
That is also acrylic. I can tell that's watercolor.
That's why I said you're undervaluing yourself.
And that was during America's 2009 recession.
Exactly. And it reflects that time through my eyes.
See, he has no money in his, like, he's asking for
it's
money.
It's no money, but the happiness comes from within. So the sun is still smiling.
This painting is also, to me, the meanest way to ride a donkey. Standing up on it like that, holding the reins. I don't know.
That's what the red signifies.
Oh, that's him? I thought that was a plant growing out of the fucking donkey's back.
That's what I said. That's mantis or something.
Why does a donkey look like a bug?
Well, I've never seen a Soviet Russian kid, so.
Is this kid, or is this person a famous painter?
He's 41. No, he's not. He's a journalist, I told you.
So he's trying to debut with the $2 million painting?
Just out the gate.
This guy's crazy.
So sick.
Why someone buys it?
So he's calling it Red Army Man on Horse, and he did have a potential buyer.
What?
But this buyer asked if the price was negotiable, which the artist was so disrespected because in his eyes, the art is already placed, the price is worth half.
Serious
I'm
offers only.
Giving a discount. How dare you, you cheap
I
bastard.
I love the ego on this dude, man.
He even said too, he's like, the price is really amazing. It is extremely low for such an artwork. The price tag represents
such an artwork.
Because then when they asked him, like, why this specific amount of money?
He's like, oh, for clicks.
No, he said the price tag is just, it just represents the money he needs right now.
What do you need for $2.3 million?
I think he gambled his money away and he owes it to the Russian mob and he needs $2 million or he's dead.
Look, if he's selling that thing
try to sell it.
If he's selling that thing for 200 bucks, nobody's clicking that news story. This is the perfect storm.
Yeah.
That's how you sell a news story.
No, and then he was also like, pitching it a little bit more, he said, "Even to me, the person who painted it, the horse's expression is really impressive."
The horse's expression.
Like, it is looking straight into your soul.
Isn't it looking off to the side?
Can't even tell where the eyes are.
Keep straight.
Yeah, I can't even tell where the eyes are.
He looks like he's like this.
You can interpret where the eyes are, Bart, if you were fucking smarter at art.
He looks like a fucking praying mantis.
Well, yeah, man, I mean, he thinks very highly of his horse and where it's gazing.
I could have swore this was the eye, which means I can't see the other eye.
Could be, but I think there's also another eye.
There's two eyes.
Yeah.
Oh, that's the horse's gaze. Okay.
But there's two eyes on one side of the horse.
Well,
there's got to be another two eyes on the other side.
There also could be a white spot.
That horse doesn't look like a horse now that I know that's the
donkey.
Eye.
I think it's a donkey, too.
Man, I could go to any elementary school right now and get something just like that.
Yeah.
Any elementary
school. Any six-year-old.
That's how I feel with most modern art, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, so they actually bring up the point in this article about, like, you know, well, I mean, we are living in a world where a banana taped to a white wall can sell for $120,000.
I can't go to those art shows and shit, because when I walk in, I want to vomit.
Vomit? Oh.
I feel disgusting.
That's art, Joe.
I feel
you
like
vomit and sell that.
Vomit on the floor.
I feel at home because I feel like I'm around other trolls. Like, that's all it is. Everyone's just fucking trolling in there, dude. I don't buy any of that shit. You think banana tape guy isn't laughing his fucking ass off with his friends after?
Did you ever see fuck, what was that called, Case? On
my kid could paint that?
No. The something buzz. The Velvet Buzzsaw.
Oh, yeah. Velvet Buzzsaw.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, did you guys see that?
I saw that one.
What is it?
Okay, so this series or something, it's about like the art world and how there was this one artist who suddenly died, and then now he has like an entire apartment filled of like originals, and it turns out that all these paintings are haunted. So whoever buys a painting ends up getting killed and then sucked into the painting.
Yeah.
But
is this a fictional thing?
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. And
you thought that was nonfiction? You thought people were getting sucked into?
So that's what that news story was.
That's a good point.
Wait. But you thought that?
I thought that.
You thought that art was haunted.
And so you don't believe in ghosts, huh?
No, I do. I do.
No, you're better than that.
I'm just trying to grasp the magnitude at which you were invested in.
Do you know that ex-first ladies and presidents have seen ghosts at the White House and shit?
And they get sucked into the painting?
Yeah, has that ever happened? Have there ever been any accounts where any presidents or first ladies were sucked into these pictures?
Do people go missing all the time?
At the White House?
But have you found the missing person in a painting somewhere, like behind the Mona Lisa?
Yeah, they were like, oh, fuck, that's crazy.
Oh, I see what you guys are saying. No missing person has ever been painted. See?
No.
You haven't put the two together.
What we're saying is,
you guys are not on my level.
No, what we're saying is no missing person has ever showed up in original art after it had been painted.
Put here.
Yeah. And so we have to be very, very precise.
Yeah. You're looking for the loophole, and I hope you get that.
Look.
Don't look up there. Look at me.
Look at me.
No, look at me.
No, listen to me.
Okay, I'm listening, but look at me.
So you're the guy in the horror movie who sees a painting that looks kind of similar to his missing friend, and he's like, that's a painting. You guys are idiots. And his friend's in the fucking painting like, yo, help me, oh, fuck.
Now, wait, is my friend doing this? Because if the painting starts doing this, I'm like, oh, shit. Something's going on. But if he's just like...
You know, it's actually quite common to hear because... In the first episode of the new Twilight Zone, someone got sucked into a painting too.
Oh, wow.
It's common.
Oh, good thing that they weren't his friend. Because he thinks that's a big joke.
Good thing it wasn't real. Your question was, is this...
is this fiction?
We tried to argue it.
You were holding on really good. You were doing a great. I liked it.
Thank you.
I applaud that.
Is this fiction maybe
my stupid ass was like valid until you spoke up and I'm like, fuck, I'm so stupid,
dude, for real. I answered it like no.
Yeah.
Wait, is it on Netflix? Because I forgot where I watched this.
Velvet Buzz?
Yes, yeah, it's on Netflix. Buzz Jake Gyllenhaal's in it.
I was thinking describing like a documentary about the it's like, oh, there's
are you back on it?
Yeah.
You circled back around the fucking block.
In the
you saw that the house was on fire. Yeah. You circled back around. Let me make sure that goddamn house was on. It is on fire. You came back.
Do you believe Chaplin's spirit is with us right now in that painting?
No, I don't.
That one's from IKEA.
Because, you know why? Because he never went missing.
Oh, that's why.
Wait, you did the Chaplin one or you did the hands?
No, the hands. No, that was Bart. No, right now I asked about the Chaplin
okay.
one.
Okay. So that one time we had an eclipse where the sun went missing, it appeared in that painting and it just stayed there.
Oh, shit. Bart, the sun is still up there. You're not even.
It went back.
No, but from that day.
He doesn't get it.
It's not the same sun.
It wouldn't stay in there. If it was rescued, the painting would be empty. Have you guys seen Back to the Future and shit?
Uh-huh.
Thank you.
That was a different picture. That was a Polaroid.
Yeah, I know.
It wasn't painted.
That's my idea.
It was just
it's not really the same.
If Back to the Future happened in the 1800s, it would have been oil paintings.
Yeah, but a camera doesn't capture things the way an artist does.
They used
in the late 1800s, they had cameras, didn't they?
Yeah, they had the one where you fucking put on your hand and go poof.
You're talking about some shit you just messed up.
Yeah.
That's what you're talking about.
Fight. You know when Lincoln was photographed? The camera was very new. I'm talking about the beginning.
Oh, guys. They used to believe that it took a
so,
take your soul.
The Native Americans
yeah,
did.
Yeah, that's true.
Right?
That's why everyone like tried to look all like, please don't take my soul during this.
You couldn't move either.
Got it.
It was all blurry if you did.
Yeah. Got it.
There's a warning for like in Australia, if you're Aborigine. Like Aboriginal or whatever, they don't like watching films or documentaries of people that are not alive today. So if they died, or like it's an old documentary, they don't want to watch it.
Really?
Yeah, so then there's a warning like, okay, if you are, you know, if you're sensitive and there are people who died.
There's people like that in America who are like, oh, it's a black and white movie? No, I'm good. Well, I don't watch those.
I remember when I was a kid and I was on the school bus, there were these couple of kids were like, you're not supposed to talk when you drive by. A graveyard is disrespectful to the dead. I'm like, the nigga's dead.
They can't hear you.
You think they're gonna come back and be like, hey man, keep it quiet down there. I'm trying to sleep here.
What if somebody is in front of you, they're not moving, you gotta fucking honk your horn or something.
Yeah, I'm gonna fucking talk. But for a while, I used to like, riding with my mom out, turning the music down by the graveyard. She was like, what are you doing? I was like, they supposed to play music by the grave. She was like, shut the fuck up.
I love your mom.
She's the worst.
Shut the fuck up.